Velur Fort Jalakanteshwara Temple. Jalakanteshwara Temple is a temple dedicated to Lord Shiva. There is an interesting story about how the temple got its name. The story goes that there once used to be a giant anthill at the place where the sanctum of the temple now stands. Due to the collection of rainwater, this anthill became surrounded by stagnant water, and at some time a Shivalingam was placed in this water and worshipped. Chinnar Bhoomi Nayaka, a Vijayanagara chieftain, had a dream where Lord Shiva asked him to build a temple at this location. Nayaka proceeded to demolish the anthill and built the temple in 1550 AD. Since the lingam was surrounded by water, which is called Jaram in Tamil, the deity was called as Jalakanteshwara, which literally translates to the Lord residing in water. Since the temple is built in the middle of a water tank, called Agiri in Tamil, there is water around the temple in the form of a garland. The water used for Abhishegam, or bathing the deity, is drawn from an ancient well called the Gangagauri Teertham, within the temple. You can easily see that the temple is a fine example of Vijayanagara architecture. It has exquisite carvings on its Koparamore temple tower along with richly carved stone pillars, large wooden gates and stunning monoliths and sculptures. The Gopuram itself is almost 30 meters in height. You should also visit the temple Mandapam or temple hall. You will find that the Mandapam is supported by many carved stone pillars with images of dragons, horses and mythical creatures called Yarlis. The wedding hall or Kalyanamatapam within the temple has a two-faced sculpture, with one face of a bull and the other of an elephant. It is quite interesting to see. Like most Shiva temples, the Jalakanteshwara temple also has a sculpture of Nandi, Lord Shiva's vehicle. Behind the Nandi statue, there is an earthen lamp, which is said to revolve when some people place their hands on it. The revolving is said to be an indication that their wishes have been granted. Go ahead and try it. Maybe the Lord may grant your wishes here. There are also statues of snakes or nagas and sculptures of two lizards, one golden and the other silver. Devotees worship these statues in order to get relief from Sarpadosham or curse of the snakes. After you've explored Jalakanteshwara temple completely, let us make our way to St. John's Church.